Hello students, today in this grammar session I will explain you the structure of sentences. Students, it is a very important lesson because by these only we will know that what is the subject, what is the predicate, what is object, these all in a one sentence. Generally we all know very well that what is subject and object. This is a very simple topic. But then also the students did mistake because they know about the noun, pronoun, adjective, adverb, everything. But they are not clear about when they see the different type of word as a place of subject or object and all. And here in this lesson, structure of sentences, we will know with the subject, with attributes parts, object with attribute parts, and what is predicate and what is complement, everything we will know in this session. Okay, so let's start with the subject. See, the subject, here are a few examples are given so that you will know that how we can identify the subject. First sentence is birds fly. Here in this sentence the word birds is a subject. Here in this sentence birds will be subject because fly is a verb. So we can take it into predicate part. The word which are before a verb, that is called subject. Whatever we are using verb before it, it is called subject. Here he works hard. Now in this sentence works is a verb and here the subject will be he. Okay, third, the poor are with us. Here are is an auxiliary verb, so the poor will be the subject of the sentence. Next, swimming is a good exercise. Here now is an auxiliary verb, so the part which is given before it will be the subject. Swimming will be the subject of the sentence. To find fault is easy. Now here again is a auxiliary verb and here the word to find fault will be called subject. So now this is the subjects of the sentence. Now second thing, here we know that these are subjects, but if I ask you that birds is called what, it is stand here as a adjective, as a adverb, as a noun, pronoun, what? So that is the main important part that you have to identify, that birds is as a noun, because generally birds is a common noun. So here the birds is standing as a noun. So we can say that birds is a noun. Here he is given. He, the word which stands instead of noun. Okay, so he will be called pronoun. The poor are with us. Now the poor word says, poor is already as a adjective. This you know very well because we all have studied about it. So the poor is called adjective and here the poor is standing as a noun, on the place of as a noun saying, because it is qualifying someone. So the poor are with us, so the poor will be adjective as noun. In the fourth sentence, swimming is a good exercise. You remember that I learned you about the gerund, word with ing. It is participle also, but the participle meaning is different and the gerund meaning is different, that you can learn in my last videos. But here you can see that swimming is given over here and the gerund, it is gerund because it is working as a noun. Here it is working as a noun. So when the word is stand as a noun, that is called gerund. So here swimming is a gerund and it is standing on the place of subject. Next, to find fault is easy. Here you will say that to find is a infinitive, but here fault is also given. It is, so it is a group of words. We can say it is a phrase or it is a group of words doing the work of a noun because it is on the place of subject. So like these are the way noun, pronoun, adjective, gerund and the group of words which are working as a noun, we can identify the subjects. So these method you have to learn properly, that how the subject is using in the sentence. Now students, subject you learn. Now I tell you about the enlargement of the subject. Enlargement of the subject is how? See, what is enlargement of the subject? In other way, it is called attribute, which are with the subject, which are with the subject word. See, group of words that does the work of an adjective. A group of word which does the work of an adjective. It means that the noun is given and it qualifies the noun. It is working as a adjective. This is called enlargement or attribute. That is called. So now you have to identify that in the subject part. First you learn that what is subject. Now in the subject part, which words is called attribute. That we will know and learn by these examples. See, the first sentence is lazy boys fail. Here, if you remember, then the subject will be lazy boys. Okay, lazy boys are the, here it is the subject. Fail is the predicate part, that we know. Now here, if the boys is given here, so boys is a noun which comes as a subject. But which type of boy? Lazy. So here the lazy will be attribute. What? Which is with the word subject, which is with the subject boys. Now see, again I am repeating that boy is a subject. Lazy boys is on the place of subject. So it is the subject of the sentence. But only the boys will be called subject, but the other words which is with the subject and which is qualified, that is called and working as a subject noun. Here it is called attribute. So these will be attribute of the sentence. Fine. Second, barking dogs seldom bite. Now here again the words barking dogs will be the subject. Now here the dogs will be subject. Dogs are barking. So here the barking will be attribute. Okay. So the barking dogs. Barking is here for dogs. So dogs is, will be the main subject and the barking will be the attribute of the subject. In the third sentence, Raman's brother is a doctor. Now here the verb is a is. And before it, the subject will be Raman's brother. Now brother, Raman's brother means what, to whom it is going to say? Who is doctor? Not Raman. The brother is a doctor. So here the brother will be the subject and the Raman's will be the attribute of the sentence. Now see, his father is not here. Now here, his father is here given there. So his will be the attribute and the father will be the subject, main subject. Okay, it is a subject. His father is on the place of subject, so it is called subject. Generally we can say, but if you have to find out the attribute, then what will you do? His will be the attribute and the father will be subject. Of bad character are shunned. Now here boys of bad character will be the subject and the bad character will be the attribute, boys will be the subject. Okay, these you know by these examples, that how we can identify the attribute and what will be the subject. Here the boys will be the subject and bad characters will be the attribute of the sentence. Now see, second thing, that this sentence, now we have to identify that lazy, which type of word is this? It is adjective. Lazy is adjective because it is qualifying the subject boys. So lazy boys. So lazy will be adjective, boys will be noun. In the second sentence, barking dogs seldom bite. Now it is participle. Participle, you know that the ing work, and it is standing as a the work which is not completing and which is continuing, and it is telling about the specifying the work which is shown in the sentence. So here barking dogs is given there, it is a continuing work also, and then it is the verb with ing, it is working here as an adjective. So when the word is work, ing word is working as a noun, that is called jiran, and when it is work as an adjective, that is called participle. Okay, so here barking is here given here as a attribute, and it is a participle form. Raman's brother, now here possession is given there, s, apostrophe s is given, so noun is in the possessive case. Fine. His father is not here, it is a possessive adjective, his is called the possessive adjective. You know very well that in adjective I told you that possessive adjective are which, if it is coming before the pronoun, which is coming before the noun, which come before the noun, that is called possessive adjective. So here it is the possessive adjective, his is here the possessive adjective, and it is the attribute part. The fifth one, a desire to succeed is necessary. Now here it is to succeed, it is the gerundial infinitive, means which is qualified to a adjective, to a adverb or a noun. So a desire, it will be here as a subject, and it is here will be the attribute part. Here it will be the attribute part and it is the subject part. Okay, so we can say that to succeed is here the attribute part. Second, boys of bad characters are shunned. Now here boys of bad characters, I told you this is the group of words. This is the group of words which is standing as a word, a subject, and here and work which is working as a adjective. So boys here will be the subject and bad character will be the attribute which is working as a adjective part. So in this sentence you'll know that lazy, barking, Raman's, his, desire to succeed and bad character are called the attribute of the sentence. So students, you learned these all, but now in this sentence I will explain you about the predicate part. Predicate part is the different part, this is was the subjective part, and attributes we learn. Now in this sentence we see the what is the predicate part. Here the left part will called predicate, here the fail will be predicate, here the seldom bite will be the predicate part. In this sentence is a doctor is called a predicate part, is not here will called predicate part, then the next is necessary is predicate, and then are shunned is also called predicate. Now see, when the subject is over and the sentence starts with a verb, that part will called a predicate part. But here you will see many times that there is also a main verb is given. So you remember that predicate part also always consists of verb. It always consists of verb. Without verb, the predicate part is not complete. Sometimes when the two verbs are given, just like that Hari's brother is lazy, or we can say that Hari's brother is working hard. So here the is will be, the verb will start the from is, the predicate part will start from is, not from work. Okay, so like this you can understand that this is the predicate part, this is subject, and that is attribute. Now again we will study about the predicate and which are having attribute part, predicate which have the attribute part. Okay students, just in a subject the extra words which is given with the subject part, that is called that are work as a adjective, that words works as an adjective. Same as in predicate part, the words which are given in the predicate part with verb, that words are work as an adverb. Okay, if it is with the subject, that word is called adjective part, it is qualifying the adjective. Same is the words which are given in the predicate part and which are with the verbs, that is working as an adverb. So that is called adverbial qualification. Now see here, extension of the predicate. Verb in the predicate may be qualified by an adverb. That verb which is qualified by an adverb, that is called adverbial qualification. Okay, how? Let's learn with example. Here the sentence is, the bulbul sings sweetly. Now identify the predicate part. This is the predicate part. Here sings is a verb, so the sweetly will be the adverbial qualification. It will be adverbial qualification. Fine. It is very easy, because the words which left the verb and the rest of the part will be the adverbial qualification in the predicate part. Second, she went home. Here the verb is, as she will be the subject, went will be the verb, and the home will be the adverbial qualification which is qualifying the verb. So this is working as an adverb. Okay, this is the predicate part. Only the went will be the verb and the rest of the verb is called adverbial qualification. Now here, he rose early next morning. He is here the subject part. Rose early next morning will be the predicate part, and here the rose will be the verb, and early next morning will be the adverbial qualification. This is called adverbial qualification. Okay, same like that, in this the bulbul will be the subject. Okay, now see, in the fourth, the teacher spoke in an angry manner. Now here the teacher will be the subject, then spoke will be the verb, and in an angry manner. In an angry manner is for spoke, for verb. So it is qualifying an verb. So here it is called adverbial qualification. Now the sun having risen, we started. Now here the subjective part is given later. So we will be here subject. Okay, started will hear the verb, and here the sun be having risen will be the predicate part, and this is called attribute qualification, adverbial qualification. Okay, so this is the ways you can identify. Now how, what is the work, what is the work of a here as an adverbial qualification? Now let's learn. Here the sings, I said verb, and it is sweetly, so it is qualifying an verb, so it is called adverb. It is here, it is working as an adverb, adverb of manner. How the bulbul sings sweetly, so here it is adverb of manner, so it is called, here it works as an adverb. Second, home, adverbial object. Here she went, but where? So object is required in the sentence, so she went home. So here home is qualifying the verb, went. So here adverbial qualification, which is called adverbial object. Here it is home, it is work as an object, but it is adverbial object. Okay, he rose early next morning. Early next morning is adverbial phrase, because here no verb is given or nothing else, it is a group of word which is working like an phrase. So early next morning is adverbial phrase. Second, the teacher spoke in an angry manner. Now here the spoke is a verb, but in which manner? Angry manner. So group of words which are working as an adverb, in an angry manner, this is a group of words which are working as an adverb, so it is called group of words which are working as an adverb. And the lastly, the sun having risen, we started. Now here it is a absolute phrase, it is a totally phrase which is given before the subject, but it is working as an adverb, so it is called adverbial qualification. So these are the way you learn now. But here you will observe one more thing, that द बुलबुल. इन द बुलबुल, बुलबुल इज द सब्जेक्ट बट द विल बी द एट्रीब्यूट. ओके, आई वॉन्ट टू से बाय दिस एग्जाम्पल दैट द विल बी सब्जेक्ट विल बी ओनली बुलबुल, नाउन इज देयर, बट द विल बी द एट्रीब्यूट पार्ट विच इज विद द नाउन. सो द इज एट्रीब्यूट एंड हियर अगेन द टीचर, तो टीचर इज ओनली विल बी द सब्जेक्ट एंड दिस इज द एट्रीब्यूट पार्ट विच इज विद द सब्जेक्ट एंड हियर द इज एन आर्टिकल एंड वर्किंग एज एन एडजेक्टिव बिकॉज द इट इज स्पेसिफाइंग दैट विच टीचर. ओके, द सन हैविंग राइजन वी स्टार्टेड, हियर इट इज ओनली द एडवर्बियल क्वालिफिकेशन. सो दिस वे नाउ यू टिल नाउ यू हैव लर्न अबाउट द सब्जेक्ट, अबाउट द एट्रीब्यूट, अबाउट द प्रेडिकेट एंड द एनलार्जमेंट ऑफ द प्रेडिकेट. लेट्स लर्न अबाउट द ऑब्जेक्ट. इन द सेंटेंस द वर्ब इज गिवन. इफ द वर्ब इज ट्रांजिटिव देन वी नो दैट द ट्रांजिटिव वर्ब रिक्वायर्स ऑब्जेक्ट, otherwise it will not make complete sense. Even the transitive verb is given in the sentence, that verb requires object and that is called the object of the sentence. Now here, how will you identify the object? Now see, if the example, if the sentence is cats catch mice, cats catch what? Mice. So catch is a transitive verb which requires an object and here it is an object is mice. Okay, so mice will be the object of the sentence and here you can say that the verb will be catch and the cats will be the subject of the sentence. Okay, second, he knows her. He knows to whom? Her. So her will be here the object of the sentence. Knows, after knows it comes and again it is a transitive verb which is not having a complete sense if there is not an object. So he knows her, her will be here object, knows will be verb and he, you know that it is a subject of the sentence. Now see the third one. The rich people should help the poor. Should help the poor is a predicate part. Should help will be the verb. Okay, should and help. There can be more than one verb. Should help will be the verb. Now here the rest of the part, the poor is there. Now you see that the help is not a intransitive verb. The rich people should help to whom? He should help to whom? To the poor. So poor is completing the verb help. So that's why it is called the object of the sentence. It is not the predicate and the enlargement of the predicate. Enlargement of the predicate part is there but it is an object. In that part it is an object part. Okay. Now see, the foolish crow tried to sing. Here the foolish will be the subject, the foolish crow will be the subject, try will be the verb and to sing will be the object of the sentence. He is trying what? To sing. So that's why to sing will be the object. We are where you can get the complete answer with that verbs. The brave Rajputs loved fighting. The brave Rajputs will be the subject of the sentence. Loud will be the verb and fighting will be the gerund, which is called the here the object. It is a gerundial noun. Fine. I do not know how to swim. Here I will be the subject, do not know will be the verb and how to swim will be the object because I do not know is not making the complete sense. I do not know is not making the complete sense. So that's why how to swim is complete the sentence. So that's why it is the object part. Here the rich people is will be the subject and the should have will be the verb. Okay. So in this way, these were the object. Now here there you can see that I use the different type of object over here. Mice is a noun. Her is will be the pronoun. And then the poor, it is the adjective.
which I use as a noun. Here the adjective is the poor will be here adjective. Second, to sing, it is an infinitive. Two plus for first form. Third, in the fifth sentence, fighting is here the ing verb, gerundial noun. And how to swim is a group of verbs which are working as a noun. So you can do and you can different the parts in one sentence. So it is easy to identify the object in the sentence. So students, you have learned that what is the object in the sentence. So till now you know very well that you can identify subject, its attribute. Second thing, predicate part, in which the verb is given and the rest of the part is called predicate. Secondly, we know that what is object in the sentence. If the verb is in transitive, if the verb is transitive, then we require an object. So you can identify and you can use object as a noun, pronoun, or many ways. Now see, many objects are having the extra verb, enlargement of the object. That is called attributes of the object. Just like subject is having attribute, so that just see, I said that lazy boy. The example was there, lazy boys. So boys will be the noun and main subject, and the lazy was the attribute of the subject, which is with the subject part. Okay, same like that, if I say that he plucked a flower, he plucked a rose, whatever. So that means that rose will be only the object. But if I say red rose, then red will be the attribute of the object, enlargement of the word. And that is here we'll call the attribute object. Let's learn with the example. See, in this sentence, we plucked red roses. Here, if you are getting confused, then what you have to do? Very first, you just identify that what is the predicate part. So you can know very well that plucked red roses is the predicate part in the sentence. Plucked will be the verb. Okay, then roses, we plucked what? We require an object, and that is completed by here roses. So here roses will be the object. Red is also the roses object, but you will see here the red word is specifying that which type of roses we have plucked. So now the red will be here attribute of the object. We can say that attribute of the object, okay? It will be the attribute of the object. So you can identify here that we is a subject, plucked is a verb, red is an attribute, and roses will be the object of the sentence. Now, second, we hurt his finger. He hurt his finger. Now here, he will be the subject, hurt will be the verb, his finger will be the object, but finger, whose finger? His finger we require because it can be anyone. So his will be here the attribute of the sent object. Here his will be the attribute of the object because his finger is an objective word, but it is an extra word, enlargement. Usko enlargement kiya hai. So that's why we can say that he hurt his finger, and here the his will be the attribute. Third, the policeman caught the wandering beggars. Now here the policeman will be the subject, but I learned you and you should know that the will be here the attribute of the subject, not any other thing. Only the will be the, it is because it is qualifying the policeman. Okay, so it is an adjective working as a noun. Here it is called the is attribute, policeman is a subject, coat is a verb, and now the wandering beggars is an object. But here the beggars will be the object, or the beggars will be the object, but wandering will be the attribute, and here the will be also attribute. So in this sentence, two attributes of objects are given, the and wondering. Okay, the and wondering, not the wondering. The is a different word and the wondering. So two attributes are given in this sentence. Fourth one, she has money to spend. Now she will be the subject. Has, we know it is the verb, and money to spend. Now money is here the object, but money, he has money, but here the verb is given for what? To spend. So here two plus verb is using, so it is called attribute, but it is an infinitive that I tell you later. Okay, so money will be the main object and the to spend is the attribute. Remember that you don't think that these attributes are not the part of an object. These are the object, but these are the attributes. It is the enlargement of the object which we have to identify. Fine. See, so in these four sentences I use the different words, and how red, so it is qualifying the word roses, so it is an as adjective. Here the attribute is red and it is called adjective. Okay, here it is adjective. Now his is what? His comes before the finger. Okay, so it is called possessive adjective. Here the his attribute, object is as a possessive adjective. Thirdly, wondering is given. Wondering is given, but it is a participle, not noun. Not gerund. Because here it is working as an adjective. So it is a participle. Wondering is here the participle form. So participle will be, okay, attribute will be participle. Here it is work as a participle. You have to read again and again, and you have to learn it again and again, so that you will be easy for it. She has money to spend. To spend is here as an infinitive. So by these four examples, I learn you that how the objects are having attributes with it, and in which form it can be used in a sentences. Now the next point is direct and indirect objects. Many of the times a sentence is having two objects. It is very difficult to identify that which object is given there. Okay, two objects are given. Teacher gave Harry a prize. The teacher gave Harry a prize. Again, the teacher gave Harry what? He gave him what? Because in this here it is two objects are given, Harry and a prize. Both are standing here as an object, not as an attribute or nothing else. Because both are separate, and these both are very important for the sentence. Because if one is given the answer of what? Harry, the teacher gave Harry what? A prize. So here it is the direct object. Sorry, here it will be for whom is given the answer of indirect, and it is given the answer of direct. Okay? The teacher gave Harry what? A prize. And the teacher gave a prize to whom? To Harry. So it will be the indirect object. Because the teacher gave a prize is a complete sentence. We don't require any object. But if one object more is given there in the sentence, and it is giving the answer of to whom, then it will be called that it is the indirect object. Okay? After verb, one more trick is there, that after verb, if the object is always comes as an indirect way. Okay? He told us a story. He told us what? A story. So a story will be the direct object. And he told a story to whom? It will be indirect object. Okay? He showed Mary a picture. What? A picture. It is a direct. And to whom? It is indirect. Fine. So like this way you can find in the sentence the object in a direct way or in a indirect way. Now students, this is the last part of the structure of the sentences. Till now we have learned everything about the object and all. If the verb is transitive verb, then we require an object. But think that if the verb is in intransitive verb, then it makes a complete sense.
Then sometimes what happened that few verbs are there which required some verb to complete it in the meaning. So just like the sky grew dark. If I say the sky grew, so grew is an intransitive verb, but it requires some verbs to make it complete sense. Okay, so we add dark. The sky grew dark. So here the word dark is complement of the verb. It is called complement of the verb. When we requires some words to make the complete sense in intransitive verb, that words are called complement of the verb. Now see here, what is required to complete the predicate is called a complement. Now here Advani is a doctor. Is, am, are, was, were, we know that these all are intransitive verbs. But here Advani is what? Here the intransitive verb requires an object. He is a singer, doctor, dancer, what? So a doctor is here completing the sentence. So here a doctor will be the complement of the sentence. Okay? And here it is standing as a noun. Second thing, it is I. It is what? It is I. So I is here as a pronoun. Here it is I is here pronoun, and I will be here the complement of the verb. Okay? So complement of the verb, it is given I. In the third sentence, the earth is round. The earth is, it is incomplete. So is even an intransitive verb, but requires a verb to complete it. Round is completing here. So round is an adjective verb which is completing the sentence. So round will be the complement of the sentence. Okay? And the last, the woman seems worried. Seems is a intransitive verb, and woman seems, how is worried? It is worried. Worried is a participle, third form of the verb. Here it is the participle. So here it is working as a participle and also the complement of the verb, because it is qualifying, seems, it is qualifying the verb. It is saying about the verb, seems how worried. So when the complement of the verb is given over here, it is called complement and it is participle. Now see, many objects are there, many transitive verbs are there which require object is given there, but that few words after the object. Some sentences transitive verbs are given, but even the object is given, then also it requires some words to make it complete. Just like we called her Pinky. Called is a transitive verb because it requires an object. So her is an object. But you see, we called her, but what? Pinky. So Pinky will be here the complement of the sentence. Okay, complement of the verb it will be. We called her Pinky. Now it is here the object complement. So it is called object complement. The policeman found him guilty. To whom? Him. Not the policeman. Found is a transitive. Him is an object, and him he found guilty. So it is qualifying the object. So here it is the complement. It is saying something about the object. So here it is object complement. So like these you can found the complement in the sentence. At last, again I want to say that in the structure of sentences, I explained you very first about the subject and the attribute of the subject. If here any attribute given, see the earth. The earth is given, the attribute is given here, the. So attribute of the sentence. Secondly, it was the predicate part in which the verb contains, a verb contains in a sentence. And after verb, the whatever the enlargement is given, that is called the predicate part. Predicate part, there is again next point was the object. Object is also having the attribute part. Okay, and the lastly it was the direct and indirect object. If the two objects are given in a one sentence, and if the answer is for, to, what and whom, then that will be direct and indirect object. And the last I explained about the complement of the sentences. So that's all you have to do, practice again and again, so that it will be easy to you to learn it and to understand the concept of it. That will be helpful to you to find the and to find the way in phrases and clauses. So keep learning and do watch again and again the video, so that it will be easy for you. And we will meet again in my next session. Till then, goodbye, take care.